We call Samaritan Aviation an adventure in faith. Let us introduce you to some individuals whose lives have been touched and the places where Samaritan Aviation is being used to improve those lives. 6-year-old Sean was born with severe back problems. A rod in his back detached from the bone and began to push up through his skin. He required emergency surgery. He was soon on his way to Salt Lake City in Samaritan 1. The surgery was a success, and we brought him home the following week. Sean has dreams of becoming a firefighter and loves airplanes. Daniel was diagnosed with lung cancer. He was too weak to fly commercially and wanted to spend his last days at home in Arkansas with his family. At the end of the flight, we were able to pray with Daniel. He passed away a few weeks later. Dr. Grant Vorster is one of over 200 volunteers who fly down to Mexico with Samaritan Aviation to donate their medical services. On a recent trip, he met Allie, the daughter of migrant farmers. Her eyesight was so poor that she was cross-eyed with a permanent squint. Allie desperately needed custom-made glasses. Dr. Vorster was able to send Allie a new pair of glasses. Now, for the first time in her life, Allie can see clearly. This baby has spinal meningitis. He needed a shunt to relieve the swelling in his head. There were three other babies in the hospital that needed the same treatment, but the hospital only had one shunt. Dr. Illamo did not want to choose which baby to save, and he asked Samaritan for help. A week later, we located 9 shunts and had them delivered to Dr. Illamo, and the babies were given a chance to live after all. This foot belongs to an 8-year-old boy in New Guinea who could not pick his foot up to walk. The local doctors could not treat his condition. Samaritan's orthopedic surgeon, Dr. David Brown, performed surgery on his foot and taught the procedure to the local doctors. The boy's life has changed now that he can walk. In each of these boxes is a medical kit from Project Cure in Denver. They are on their way to remote health outposts in the jungle of New Guinea. One of these kits was delivered by a Samaritan team to Nagway Village, which is a 14-day hike from the hospital or a 1-hour flight followed by a short trek. Missionary Greg Greenlaw, who runs the health post in Nagway, sent us a note the week after receiving the supplies.
We had a guy who got caught by the mean end of a wild boar. He was torn up left, right, center, and we sutured him up loosely so the infections would weep. It was over 30 stitches. Everything we used to patch him up came from your supplies. Thank you for being such good Samaritans.
WEWAC is on the north coast of Papua New Guinea. There is one hospital for 500,000 people. Most of the people live on small islands and in remote villages with no access to health care. This region is in great need, but help is on the way. This float plane and these families are headed to New Guinea to provide air ambulance, community health, and ministry services. Samaritan Aviation is about showing God's love through action.